4x4 TV, the television show for back road enthusiasts and backcountry adventurers.
Okay, now if you've got a lot of truck chores to do, and by that I mean a lot of hauling and a lot of towing, you need a real truck. Even though a lot of the half tons are full size and they've got some big V8s in them, you need more. You need something like a 2500 HD or a Super Duty, and something with diesel power. Now, this GMC 2500 HD has the Duramax and the Allison transmission. It's a truck that we've added to our fleet to use for towing our trailers around, weekend warrior, ATV trailers, but we're gonna start by testing it like we would any other truck to find out how well it does against the competition. So let's find out right now. I know I've said this before, but the truth is, when you need a real truck, you need a real truck. You need something that can tow anything, that you can hook behind it, and haul everything that you can fit in the bed. And all that sounds pretty simple. Just get a big truck with a big engine and be done with it. But here in the real world, there are a few other things that we need to consider. Such as, will it cost less than my house? Will I be able to use it for anything other than just towing my ultra-humongous Maximus Haulingus trailer out to the trailhead? Will it fit into the Walmart parking lot without a harbor captain? And will it actually be comfortable enough to use as regular transportation out on the public roads, assuming that I, like most, will need to use it as a daily driver, as I only make enough to afford one car per family member. First of all, although there's a lot of hype about the competition in the full-size truck market, heating up with the new F-150, the Hemi-powered Ram, and the Japanese invasion of the so-called full-size Toyota Tundra and the Nissan Titan, when you want a real full-size truck, there's still only the big three that you can turn to. For the ultimate truck, the only choices are the Dodge with its Cummins diesel, the Ford Super Duty with its Power Stroke, or the focus of this test, the General Motors Duramax diesel. First, let's get the power question out of the way. The turbocharged Duramax diesel engine, coupled to the Allison 5-speed automatic transmission, will pull anything that you can hook behind it. It'll never complain, overheat, hesitate, or wobble. From there, it's nothing more than that old question, do you really know what you want? In a truck, that is. Because GM, like almost every manufacturer today, offers such a vast array of options that it's very easy to get confused. Before anything else, you need to decide if that diesel option is worth the extra money. Then there's cab size, regular, extra, or crew. Then there's bed size as well, the shorter 6.5-foot bed or the longer 8-footer. Then there's two-wheel drive versus four-wheel drive, leather or cloth, manual or automatic, bench or buckets, AM or XM. You know, it's easy to just buy whatever's on the dealer lot and then worry about justifying your decision later. But let's get a bit more specific. They say you need to put somewhere around 200,000 miles on your truck before the added cost of the diesel package offsets the difference in fuel mileage. While that might be true, there are a couple of other items to consider. First, the resale of a diesel is better than a similar equipped gas truck, and that should only increase as the price of fuel goes up. And second, diesels have an abundance of torque, and it's torque that tows. Now, while cab size is a personal thing, and the smaller, typically the better for maneuverability, the larger the cab, generally the better the resale. And we've always said that we prefer the structural integrity of crew cabs over extended cabs. Bed size tends to be an important decision for numerous reasons. The advantages of the shorter bed is that, once again, a shorter truck is more maneuverable. And I've always said that as long as you can only fit one ATV in the long bed, there's little advantage of it over a short bed. My argument for two-wheel drive versus four-wheel drive is based on two factors. If you ever go off-road, or especially if you go off-road towing a trailer, the added cost of the four-wheel drive system will certainly offset itself by not needing that tow truck to retrieve you. The rest of the decisions are up to you and your personal tastes. Our truck was the SLT model, which included everything in the GMC books to make your truck experience as luxurious as possible, including heated and power adjustable leather seats with memory locations, XM satellite radio, OnStar, automatic dual zone HVAC controls, a 6 CD in-dash Bose stereo system, and an onboard computer for mileage, trip functions, maintenance schedule, and more. On our GMC, the quality of construction, both inside and out, was on par with what you'd expect from the Japanese, and the ride, especially for a heavy-duty truck, was quite nice. The good, incredible performance coupled to an awesome transmission, comfortable interior with a quality feel. The bad? An outdated interior design and a price that makes your first house look cheap. The bottom line? Perhaps the best of the old school trucks, including all the great things as well as all the bad.